Let me tell you a tale of a young little boy who lived on a sheep farm in southeast Leroy. This boy had a name, and that I'll tell, he went by the name of Henry Pretzel. He had two loving parents, a mum and a dad, and an aged old grandma who lived in Riyadh. His dad, he loved trains and models galore, and his mum had a wheel and no legs at all. Now Henry was normal, except for one thing, but isolation and sadness was all it would bring. For he had one nose, two eyes and two ears, but where our mouth is, he had nothing.
Henry, would you like some apple pie? What's that? I can't hear you. Oh, well, looks like I'm just going to have your share.
Besides from the teasing, his life was quite good. He worked for his parents, like every boy should. But he was missing something else. Something elsewhere. But he didn't know what. Henry was left in despair. So on Sunday he went to the market to sell his wool that he'd shaven and knitted quite well. He'd had a great day and sold all of his wool and headed home with his pockets almost full. At the end of the market, at the very last store, Henry saw something and he was immediately in awe. It wasn't too small, but it wasn't too tall. In fact, it was the best size of all. From the moment Henry saw it, he wanted nothing more than that cuddly, fuddly little thing in that store.
Hey, Henry, you're home. How did the market go? Did you sell it?
What's that?
Is this what you spent our money on? This
Henry had never seen his father this mad. Henry, he was sure he hadn't done anything bad. All he wanted was a nice, caring friend. A friend that would be with him till the very end. The words that were said hurt him and his chum. He was hurt enough now, and he wanted to run.
Go to your room!
So late that night, when everything was silent, he climbed out his window and left. Henry had got together an act oh so brilliant. It was fun, entertaining, and oh so very different. He would leave the entire crowd in shock and awe, although they'd expect something little and small. The judge was a large, plump, stern bear who had no emotion. He did not laugh or care. The sheep went first. It was Henry's turn. What What did Henry do that was so terribly wrong? He spun his hat in time with that song. He'd lost his job. He'd lost a friend. He drove his father round the bend.
Welcome home, Henry. I'm sorry we fought.
And luckily for little Henry, his family was kind and friendly. But still deep in his heart was the sheep he had bought. But little did young Henry know, the sheep did not enjoy the show. But Henry didn't know. Oh no. One day, Henry sat in his field with his two little sheep. Henry sat in his field and he started to weep. He sat there in tears. He sat for a while. When his friends lit on, and Henry grew his smile.